wisdom come on this morning in the name of Jesus. And we forever give in your name the glory, the honor, and the praise. And it's in Jesus' name that we say amen and amen. Somebody give God a hand clap of praise. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, you may be seated. You may be seated. You may be seated. Hallelujah. I just want to just give y'all a scripture right here. This morning, I'm going to teach. I saw that this is Logos. We're going to talk this word on this morning. Because I can preach, but I'd rather teach. Amen. I believe that it's very important for the body of Christ to be able to be taught the word. Thank you. I'm going to go to Isaiah 40:31. I'm going into the King James Version. And it says that, but they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. That's my first scripture here. My second scripture, and pretty much my foundational scripture, is where I want to stand right here. It's found in the Gospel of John, chapter 5, verse 1 through 9. And this is the New King James Version. And the Bible says, after this, there was a feast of the Jews, and Jesus went up to Jerusalem. Now there is in Jerusalem by the sheep gate a pool, which is called in Hebrew Bethesda, having five porches. In these lay a great multitude of sick people, blind, lame, paralyzed, waiting for the move of the waters. For an angel went down at a certain time, somebody say a certain time, into the pool and stirred up the water. Then whoever stepped in first after the stirring of the water was made well of whatever disease he had. Now a certain man was there who had an infirmity 38 years. When Jesus saw him lying there and knew that he already had been in that condition a long time, he said to him, do you want to be made well? Verse 7 says, the sick man answered him, sir, I have no man to put me into the pool when the water is stirred up. But while I am going, another steps down before me. Jesus said to him, rise, take up your bed and walk. And immediately the man was made well, took up his bed and walked. Oh, glory, the word of the Lord right here. But I want to define the word. You probably kept hearing this word. Somebody say wait. I want to define this word here. Wait in the Hebrew is called kavod. Kavod. And if I have my Bible scholars here that love taking notes, that is Q-A-V-A, but it's pronounced kavod, which is K-A-W hyphen or slash V-A-W. And that means to wait, look for, hope, expect, to wait or look eagerly for. And I also want to define renew. Somebody say renew. Renew is to pass away, go through, grow up, change. Oh, here we go. When the Bible talks about they that wait on the Lord shall renew. Somebody say renew. Renew their strength. It means to pass away, to go through, to grow up, to change. This is the stage that transformation takes place. This is called the metamorphosis stage. This is a process of transformation from immature form to an adult form. Let me break this thing down. I say I'm going to teach today. Let me share this with you. There was a story of a little boy that was at his house, and he was looking afar off, and he was looking at the tree. And in the tree, he saw this was a cocoon-shaped item that was in a tree. And every day that he would pass by this tree, he kept seeing that the piece of the cocoon was kind of breaking off a little bit. And this little boy was very intrigued with this cocoon. And as he was looking at this cocoon, he said, "Look like something is coming out of this cocoon here." And as something was coming out, it showed that it was a wing that was coming out. The butterfly was flapping his wing. And as the butterfly was flapping his wing, the little boy thought, he said, "You know what? I keep seeing this cocoon with this little, look like it's a wing of a butterfly. He keeps flapping his wing. I think I'm going to go and help him out." So the little boy went into his house. As the little boy went into his house, he went and got some scissors. And he went and cut open the cocoon. And as he cut open the cocoon, he said, "Okay, Mr. Butterfly, you can fly." The butterfly wasn't able to fly. The butterfly was into a paralyzed condition. That's what I'm saying. My question to you, who been enabling you? Somebody been enabling you? I feel the Holy Spirit right now. I say, who's been enabling you? Have you been enabling yourself? Have you been around folks that been enabling you? I come all the way to Opelousas, Louisiana to tell you this. What are you waiting for? Tell your neighbor, what are you waiting for? Touch and say, "Neighbor, what are you waiting for?" Oh, let's go a little deep. I'm going to get a little deep up in here this morning. The Bible says in Isaiah 40, 29, 31, it says, "He giveth thee power to the faint." I say, "He giveth power to the faith, and them that has no might, he increaseth strength." Now that word might means physical strength. He increaseth strength, meaning power, strength, might. Even the youths, I'm talking to y'all too, young folks. Even the youth, it says that even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall. For my young generation, the enemy is trying their best to try to stop you all. As it was talked about in, as Pastor Betty was reading back in 2000, I had a youth ministry going, and I used to minister to the young folks. But I had a thing that I did, like a drama type of thing with the Christian rap. And the thing is, it was a prophetic CD that I called Pump Them Hands Up. And back in 2000, I'm seeing what's going on today. So the young people, what it is, the enemy trying his best to try to sift you all, because y'all can be able to tap into this power. One thing about a young generation, y'all in a point right now to whereas dealing with computers and things of that nature is taking you on a different level. But you got to be careful, because the thing is that I even talked about the internet on Pump Them Hands Up. It's a lot of information that's being stirred up on the computer, right? So the thing is, I want to share this with you right here, is that there was a young man, and y'all probably heard this story, that he was on the Carnival cruise, and he jumped off the Carnival cruise into the water. This was at about 1:40 a.m. from the deck four, Monday, according to NBC News. He can be seen climbing on a lifeboat and jumping off from there. Lapoli said, Barnett's mother, Elisha Reed, told Business Insider that her daughter was previously informed that there was no footage of what happened. Something doesn't add up. Reed told Insider on Tuesday, "I'm going to find out. I will get answers." As I look at Matthew 16:19, it says, "And I will give you the keys to the kingdom of heaven. And whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven. And whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven." That word keys is power and authority of various kinds. That word bind is to tie, to fasten with chains. So, beloved, I'm here to let you know that God has given us the keys to the kingdom. So many times when I see people and I see people from afar, because I do a lot of traveling, the beloved, the people of God, the churches, they're not operating in their authority. They're not operating in their power. They'll allow the the world to come into the church. So what God is saying on this morning right here is that we got to walk in our authority. And once again, my question is, what are you waiting for? Let me take my time. I'm gonna get where I really want to go right here. But I want you to know that when I'm seeing these spirits right here, Pastor them talked about that last time. Apostle talked about that. Those marine spirits. I don't know if y'all know about the marine spirits. I don't want to go too deep up in here. But you see, the marine spirits is dealing with that water. See, I just did a video to talk about the healing rivers. And the healing rivers is not dealing with nothing demonic. The healing, you get into that, tap into the healing rivers, healing can take place. Amen. So when we start talking about the water, you got to be careful about these marine spirits. And I'm going to just keep it right there. But I want you to understand that right now I'm going to bind up those depression spirits. I'm going to bind up them suicidal thoughts right now in the name of Jesus. Robo shata. We bind up the depression spirit right now in the name of Jesus, Lord God. I thank you, Lord God, that you have free course in this house right now. Robo shata. Hallelujah. This is the Logos house. This is the house of the word. Hallelujah. The Bible said where the word is, where the spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. Hallelujah. For the word is a lamp unto my feet and a bright light into my pathway. Hallelujah. Robo shanda raboko. So I break the spirit of heaviness off you right now. Raboko shanda debika sanda robo shata. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Father God, we just thank you right now. And as I go back to John chapter 5, verse 1-9, that's what I want to stick at. It says, at this there was a feast of the Jews, and Jesus went up to Jerusalem. Now there is in Jerusalem by the sheep gate. Like I said, I want to teach today. The sheep gate represents the experience of salvation made available by the cross. That Jesus was the Lamb of God that takes away the sins of the world. The sheep gate then speaks to us of the cross and the sacrifice that was made by our sins. Let me share this with you right here. The origin of the sheep gate. Somebody say the sheep gate. The origin of the sheep gate is that was the entrance for sheep entering into the temple compound from the sheep's market, where lambs were sold for sacrifice in the temple. And the sheep pool later was known as the Pool of Bethesda, where sheep were washed for sacrifice. This same scripture in John, it talks about the Pool of Bethesda. This is the same spot where sheep used to go when they're getting ready to go to the slaughter. They were going to this pool. They will wash them before they go into the slaughter. A pool which is called in Hebrew Bethesda, which means house of pity or mercy, having five porches. In these lay a great multitude of sick people, blind, paralyzed, waiting for the move of the waters. There was waiting for the move of the waters. Fourth verse says, for an angel went down at a certain time. Somebody say a certain time. Let me help you out with that word. That word certain time, that word time right here is Greek in kairos. Kairos. That's a certain time. That's a certain season. Kairos. That is a fixed, opportune, or seasonal time. Into the pool and stirred up the water. Then whoever stepped in first after the stirring of the water was made well of whatever diseases he had. Now a certain man was there who had an infirmity. We talked about 38 years. When Jesus saw him lying there and knew that he already had been in the condition a long time. That word long time, that word right there is chronos. Chronos, meaning long or short period or a space of time. He said to him, do you want to be made well? Not everybody want to be made well. My background is in mental health and substance abuse. Not everybody want to be made well. Some folks like to be in their pity. And I just talked about that, that Bethesda was called the house of pity. You follow what I'm saying? You got the lame folks walking up in there. I'm sure even that man for 38 years, he just stayed right there waiting for somebody to, I just waiting for somebody to put me into the pool. What are you waiting for? Waiting for somebody to give you a handout. What are you waiting for? Well, when I can just start praying to my Heavenly Father, the Bible lets me know that the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Come on, somebody. Come on. You know, he leading me beside the still waters. He restored my soul. My God shall supply all of my needs according to thy riches and glory. That's through Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. I'm not dependent on the government to take care of me. Come on, somebody. I believe in the government, and I believe there's a temporary type of situation. Hallelujah. But it's not to be connected and stuck on it. Let me share with somebody about this right here. You see, the welfare system was only supposed to be temporary. The welfare system wasn't supposed to be long term. You follow what I'm saying? Back in the Great Depression, that's when that started to develop. You follow what I'm saying? Then, so the thing is this. Now check this out. When we have crisis, we have the government come in and help us out. Just like we had COVID, right? People still abuse the system. You follow me? I never forget. There was a hurricane that passed through. I think it was Hurricane Andrew. It was real big in New Iberia area. At the time, I think it was Kathleen Blanco was the governor of Louisiana. All homeowners, I think they gave them $2,000. Right? Now check this out. I had a credit card that I had. I used the credit card to purchase my CDs for Pump Them Hands Up. I took that $2,000 and paid the credit card off. But check this out. I got $2,000. The credit card, I negotiated with the credit card company to drop that price down. You follow me? Because I had some cash. So being that I was a homeowner, I didn't have no problems with the house or anything. But all homeowners was given $2,000. So I used the $2,000 to pay off debt. Hallelujah. Some of you all trying to get your credit straight. Some of y'all probably want to try to look and buying a house or something. Get your credit right. I'm going to be tapping to all certain things now, because my thing, once again, as Pastor Betty said, my mission is to get a generation to higher heights. That's my mission. The body of Christ got to get to the next level in their giving, in their prosperity. Because we are the largest consumers. Our people are the largest consumers, but we don't own nothing. Come on, somebody. I know it's tight, but it's right. I'm going to talk about it. What are you waiting for? Robo shanta ta 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 ta. If I'm stepping on some toes, just say ouch or amen. Oh, glory, glory. Father God, I thank you, Lord God. I want to bless your people. I'm looking right here at Mark chapter 5, verses 25 to 34. I told you I'm going to do some teaching in here. I'm going to do some teaching. Mark 5, the Gospel of Mark 5, verse 25 says, now a certain woman had a flow of blood for 12 years. Somebody say 12 years. And had suffered many things from many physicians. She had spent all that she had and was no better, but rather grew worse. When she heard about Jesus, she came behind him in the crowd and touched his garment. For she said, if only I can touch his clothes, I shall be made whole. I want to kind of break this scripture down right here. I'm sure we all heard this scripture before. They talked about the woman. But what, this is what I want you to show, I want to show you about this woman, is that she just wasn't waiting. Her faith was already there. Her mindset was already there, functioning to where it is. If I can just touch the hem of his garment. She wasn't waiting around. She heard about this man named Jesus, how he was healing, how he was delivering. So she was like, I need to get to this man. I need to get to this place. I need to get to Logos. I need to get to this place where they got this word is at. I got to get to where the word is at. Robo shata. You follow what I'm saying? I don't need to just be staying in my house, just looking at the TV. You know, I'm not worried about Black Friday, Shanda. But I need to get to this house to get some words so I can be strengthened. It's like spinach, like Popeye. It's sweeter than a honeycomb. Come on, somebody. Oh, taste and see the goodness of the Lord. You know, I love to taste him. I love to see him. You see, the word is a lamp into my feet. I love that word. You see what I'm saying? Because in the time of your darkness, the word would be a lamp into your feet, and then it gets you out the dark place. You follow what I'm saying? No need to go to the horoscope. No need to go to Sister Susie. Come on, somebody. And Sister Cleo and all of them. No need to go to them and burn them candles. You don't need to do all that stuff. Let me tell you. Oh, shandada. So right there is tapping you into a demonic realm right there. You see, when you start playing with fire, you get burnt. Shandada. I see when you start playing with fire. I'm going to stay right here. When you start playing with fire, you get burnt. Let me share this with you right here. I know God is real. God has been too good to me to be playing games. I don't play games, people. I don't play games. If I'm connected to some folks and they not trying to be God for real, man, I'm cutting it off. I don't have time to be playing no games, man. Oh no, God is real. I just wanted to share some testimonies about me, as Pastor Betty was already sharing in there. I just wanted to just give you some experience to whereas, as you hear, I talk a lot about healing. I'm staying in my path. I stay in my lane. Like I said, my background is in mental health and substance abuse. But the thing is that because of my background, my mother was murdered when I was 6 years old. Think about a young boy with his mother being murdered at 6 years old. I could have been an angry man, young brother. I could have been a very angry individual. But because I had some grandparents who loved me, you follow me, who made sure that I go to church, even though we was Catholic, I had a praying grandmother. I had a praying grandmother. When I was at Southern University, it was my grandmother's prayers. She would wake up every morning at 3 a.m. to pray. She was a prayer warrior. That's where I got it from, woman of God. 3 a.m. in the morning, she would pray. And when I was on a campus at Southern University, I got a phone call in the middle of the night. This individual started talking and started talking to me. And she was like, "You go to Southern?" I'm like, "Yeah. God has great things in store for you." I'm like, "What? Come on. Really?" And I already had a friend that was ministering to me already. She told me that I was dying. And, you know, when a person is young in the prophetic, you know, they might share information like young Joseph. They share stuff. You're like, "What the word are they talking about?" So I'm getting scared now, right? That very friend used to feed me Charles Stanley cassettes. Young people, y'all don't know about them cassettes. Y'all don't know about them cassettes, young folks. Them cassettes, right? So it used to go into my spirit. It used to feed into my spirit all the time, you know? So, but to make a long story short, when I went, this person that I met on the phone, she told me to whereas there's a job that you can apply for. I'm like, okay. My background was in psychology. I'm like, cool. So when I went and met this individual. This person was like almost like a dwarf, man. The lady scared me, you know. But she gave me the information for me to put my resume in at this group home. And once I went to the group home and interviewed, passed the test with flying colors. I went and got my assignment. I tried to call this lady back. Phone disconnected, couldn't even reach him no more. I went to one of my other friends, went to talk to her dad, who was a prophet. He said, man, you encountered an angel. I said, wow. All my life, I've been encountering certain things like that. You follow what I'm saying? So the thing is that I encountered that right before I was about to get saved, because I got saved in the back of Southern University in my truck. This my same friend that was ministering to me with them Charles Stanley CDs. You see what I'm saying? That's why I'm saying you got to watch who you're connected with. You see, when they're for your best favor, they'll help you out. You follow what I'm saying? So be careful who you're connected with. And I start seeing a whole lot of things when I was young. I'm just sharing a testimony, y'all, with y'all. This is not, I didn't even put this in my notes right here. But I just felt I just need to share that, because at an early age, I started battling with the demonic. At an early age. And that's when I want to share that with the young people, because sometimes that you might be going through some things and you don't know it's a spiritual battle. You follow what I'm saying? Even our generation, our mature individuals. You follow what I'm saying? So I want to give y'all some gifts and some keys to help you all out, because in my sleep, demons used to jump on me. Somebody be like, what? Demons jumping on you? I can't tell it to everybody. Folks be like, this dude crazy. I worked in mental health. I already know. You follow what I'm saying? Shanda da da bo shanda. So what I'm saying is that we're dealing with a spiritual battle. We wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities. Wickedness in high places. Them principalities is in the high places. That's why it's good to have a prayer life, people of God. You got to have a prayer life. Those prayers changes things for real. Thank you, Lord. And as I was looking at Mark 5, it was talking about this woman, talking about if I can just touch. You see, inside of herself, her faith was being built up. If I can just touch the hem of his garment. And as I was listening to the individuals that was speaking today, they were saying that they're praying for men and they're praying for things. And when you start praying for things, and when you start believing within yourself, things are manifest. Things have come forth. But you got to believe. The Bible says this: whosoever shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed and be thou cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, but believe that whatsoever things that he saith, he shall have. He shall have whatsoever he saith. He said whosoever. Not just the believer, not just the born again person. Whosoever. So why the world functioning and stuff in the church is still not? Whosoever. Take heed to that. The 29th verse says that immediately the fountain of her blood was dried up, and she felt in her body that she was healed of the affliction. And Jesus, immediately knowing in himself that power had gone out of him, turned around in the crowd and said, who touched my clothes? Now check this out. The 31st verse says this: but his disciples said to him, you see the multitude thronging you. That word thronging, I'm going to define that. And you say, who touched me? That word thronging, thronging, means to press together. To press on all sides. Just think, if there's a multitude of people and folks is all jam-packed and like, almost like sardines. This woman, her faith was like, if I can just touch the hem of his garment, what are you waiting for? Sha-da-da-da-bo-sha. What are you waiting for? 32nd verse says, and he looked around to see her who had done this thing. But the woman, fearing and trembling, knowing what had happened to her, came and fell down before him and told him the whole truth. And he said to her, daughter, your faith has made you well. Go in peace and be healed of your affliction. You see, the woman that was fearing and trembling, she was reverencing it. That trembling is that she was afraid. You see, when you start to worship, you start to worship the Father. Father, I worship you. You start to worship. You're humbling yourself. You start to worship. You start to worship. Can I give you a secret nugget? That's where the power is at. Woo! I feel the anointing. Y'all say y'all come to get some teaching. I'm going to teach today, boy. I'm going to give some secrets on today. I'm going to give some nuggets on today. That's where the power is at. In your worship. In your praying. Come on. Paul and Silas prayed and sang praises to him. They praised God and sang praises. And the Bible said that the bands were loosed. They was praising their way out of situations. Come on, somebody. Praise is your weapon. Praise is your weapon. You start praising God. Halal, I start talking. Halal, hallelujah. Lord, you're so worthy. Bless your name, Jesus. We don't just say that religiously. That is the highest praise. Hallelujah. That's the highest praise. Because he's worthy to be praised. Praise is your weapon. So the woman was fearing. She reverenced God and trembling, being afraid. I remember I preached the word called How Bad Do You Want It? That was on 1 Kings 17, 7 through 17, about the widow of Zarephath. How bad do you want it? And you saw that that woman of Zarephath, that widow woman, she wanted it bad, right? This woman was already made up in her mind. If I can just give me some cake, me and my son, we're going to die. Her mind was already made up. But it took a prophet of God to come and turn her situation around. Woman, if you could just feed me first. You see, when you sow a seed like that, if you could just sow that seed into that prophet of God life right there, of that cake. The Bible said that her oil never ran dry. Never ran dry. You see what I'm saying? Because God had ordained the prophet of God to go to the woman of Zarephath. It was part of the script, if you will. It was part of the script. You follow what I'm saying? And she was obedient. Now let me add another nugget to that. She had a son. The son had died. Elijah went up there and prayed for that son. Put his body over that boy, and that boy started breathing. You follow what I'm saying? When you're dealing with somebody for real, you're unlocking a key to your blessing. You're unlocking a key to your breakthrough. I feel the power of God. Glory. You see what I'm saying? You see, and these folks that been hurting folks, they need to repent. The false prophets and folks that's been playing the folks, they need to repent. Because I'm telling you right now, going into 2003 into 2004, God is about to expose some stuff. And ain't no more playing church no more. God see a people that's hungering and thirsting after his righteousness. God should not be mocked. Folks can't be playing folks. Can't, not God's people. No. That's why I'm saying, what are you waiting for? After everything is over, I want to start praying for folks, because there's some things that's going to be unlocked in you. Ain't no more just waiting. What you waiting for? When you wait, the Bible say that they that wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. You shall mount up with wings. What you getting ready to mount up for? You getting ready to mount up with wings of eagles. Y'all know about the eagles? The eagles ain't waiting for nobody. Come on, somebody. When you mount up with wings as eagles, they shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. So I'm speaking to you right now. Those gifts is being stirred up right now inside of each and every individual. Those gifts is being stirred up. Hallelujah. God wants to use you. Don't matter if it's in the grocery store. Don't matter if it's on your job, in your family. I thank God for the blessed men of God that are here on this morning, using them in their families. Hallelujah. God is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we may ask or think, but it's according to the power that worketh on the inside. According to the power that worketh on the inside. No more we can just be talking, all praise the Lord, hallelujah. But are you walking in authority? Can you loose the shackles and set the captives free? Can you have a prayer for somebody and your prayer go through into the heavens? That's what I'm talking about. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And as we go back, the scripture talks about the sick man answered him, say, sir, I have no one to put me into the pool when the water is stirred up, but while I'm coming, another steps down before me. That's a complainer. You're making excuses. You follow what I'm saying? Don't make no excuses. Stop making excuses. You got to take an inventory of yourself. What I've been making excuses about? What I've been complaining about? What are you waiting for? Ah, glory. Shandaraboko shandara. Oh, glory. I want to share this with you right here. I'm about to get ready to start just flowing in the spirit right now. I'm just flowing in the spirit. Father God, I thank you for your Holy Ghost, Lord God. Open up my eyes that I may see into the spirit right now, Lord God. Shandarabo shandarabo koshata. What I want you to understand that in these scriptures here, that there was a man that was waiting around 38 years, lame, and that pool, the Bethesda, that word Bethesda was the house of pity. I want to let you know, don't matter what you go through, don't have a pity party. Don't sob in what you're going through, because we all go through it. I could have been a young man at 7, 8 years old, could have been talking about my mother was murdered and pulled me. You follow what I'm saying? But I had my grandparents that was instilling the word inside of me. I got inside the band, and the trumpet was my counselor. I would stay nights and playing the music. And when I got saved, I was studying the word. I'm just sharing about what I was going through. Ain't nothing special about me. God is ready to do some great things inside of you all on today. Hallelujah. He's ready to do things exceedingly, abundantly, above all that you may ask. What are you asking? Let me tell you something. God is more than just asking for, give me a nice TV on Black Friday. Come on, somebody. You know what I'm saying? Solomon was asking for wisdom. You see, when you start asking for spiritual things, God will bless you with the material things. The Bible says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. I'm just having free course up in here this morning. I just love that, like this woman of God right here, just praying right here. Woman, I see God has some great things in store for you, woman. You are a prayer warrior. I see God is about to do great and mighty exploits in you, because I see that you don't mind worshiping. That's where the power lies. But I see too, as I'm tapping into the spirit right now, I see you've been praying for some individuals. Am I talking foolish or am I for real? This one particular individual, you've really been crying out for this particular individual. I'm here to let you know that God said it's going to be all right. Shada da bobo shata. It's going to be all right. It's going to be all right. It's going to be all right. Angels, I put an assignment right now for my angels to go and talk to this individual. You know who it is. I'm not going to broadcast it, but you know who it is. I just saw it right quick. You know what I'm talking about. God told me to let you know this. Woman of God, my daughter, I'm taking care of it. It's in his hands right now. The Bible said, cast his cares on you. Cast his cares on him, for he careth for you. Hallelujah. 1 Peter 5:7. Casting your cares upon him, for he cares for you. The Amplified Version said that you cast your anxieties, your concerns. So you let me know that you've been casting your cares, and he's concerned about you. And this individual that you're praying for is going to be all right. Oh, hallelujah. Glory. Prophetic flow. Prophetic flow. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want to pray for some more folks on this morning. It's afternoon. I want to pray for some more folks. I want to be obedient. Hallelujah. What are you waiting for? That's my message. What are you waiting for? You see, some people have been like the cowardly lion on the Wizard of Oz, lacking courage. Some have dreams lying dormant. Some looking to start a business. Some saying, I need to get my credit straight. But what are you waiting for? Some folks in some relationships that needs to be restored. Some folks might be connected to some people that some bad relationships. You got to pray for them folks. You got to pray for them individuals. Because you got to watch who you're connected to. Got to be watchful who you connect. You see, the enemy is so slick to whereas he'll bring folks around you that you think is cool, but they're plotting against you. I'm praying for your discernment right now. Praying for your discernment right now. I come to Opelousas to be a blessing. Jesus is walking in the building right now. My heavenly angels, I pray that you go down each and every aisle, angels, right now. Go down each and every aisle. Touch right now. Touch right now. Each and every aisle. Touch the individuals right now. I'm looking into the spirit right now. Robosha. Rekandere debosha. Robosandere ko rabasian da da boko shata. Hallelujah. Shanda da da boko shata. Da boko shata. I'm breaking the back of the enemy right now. Roboko shata. Pharaoh, let my people go. Robo sheka raba. Fire anointing fall in this place. Shanda da da boko rababa shata. Kurababa shandere kurababa baba baba. Shanda da 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 kurababa.